for this day. Holy Spirit, we pray you fall fresh on us. Let your will be done. Your kingdom come in our lives, and we'll be so careful and prayerful to give thy name the glory. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Truly, it's a blessing to be here with you tonight. Always a blessing to be to hear under the unction of the sound of a voice of someone proclaiming the word of God. I'm thankful for Pastor Johnson for giving us the opportunity to stand. It's always a blessing. I'm thankful for you to come and sit. It's so many cars passing by, so many people around, you know, and we all looking for something. We all going somewhere. And individually, we wonder why we are where we are. But the good thing is, we want to be where God placed us. I know I'm right about it because in this story, there's a young lady who the Bible say she had an issue of blood. And if I was preaching this thing, I'd talk about issues. Because we all have them, Miss Carol. We all have our personal issues, our personal circumstances, our personal problems. But this woman, the Bible said, her issue was blood. And we know the story. She bled. She had this issue, this circumstance, this situation for 12 years. That's what Mark recorded. In the 25th verse of Mark, the 5th chapter, it reads, "And a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years and had suffered many things of many physicians and had spent all that she had and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. When she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment, for she said, 'If I may but touch his clothes, I shall be made whole.' And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. And immediately Jesus, knowing in himself that power had gone out of him, turned him about in the press, in the crowd, and said, 'Who touched me?' And his disciples said unto him, 'Thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and sayest thou, who touched me?' And he looked round about to see her that had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth. And he said unto her, 'Daughter, thy faith had made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of thy plague.'" What a blessing, Miss Carol, young ladies. As we read this and studied this, and we asked the Holy Spirit to show us what you want to tell us about this healing, about this miracle. Because when Pastor read it, he was on his way to Jairus' house to heal his daughter. But Jairus told him, "You don't even have to go. If you just say it, I believe that thing gonna be done." And while he was on his way to Jairus' house, the Bible say something stopped him. The throng, the people pressed him. Now my first question I looked for, Pastor, was who were these people? Are you making Jesus stop? Cause he coming by. He moving, he know just, he said, "I'll never leave you nor forsake you." But does our circumstances, our troubles, our problems, our issues make us look for everybody, listen to everybody but Jesus? Do we know that he's near? Well, evidently she didn't, because in the beginning, in verse 25, it said, and a certain woman which had an issue of blood. So the first thing God gave me was a serious issue. We all have our personal serious issues. Everybody, and we talked about it last week, Miss Carol, we were sitting at the table, and if God, young lady, told all of us to come put your issue on this altar, and we all place our issues on this altar, and he say, now go back and get any issue you want off the altar. Guess what, Pastor? We'll all get our same issues. And most of the time, we spend life wondering about other people and what's going on, and we miss Jesus. And he right there trying to love us, trying to tell us, opening the door for us, trying to tell us to come. You ain't too weak. Come on in. But this lady taught me a lesson. So first, we got serious illnesses. You have to, within yourself, know I got a serious issue. This lack of faith, whatever your issue is. No trust, loneliness. Because this woman was lonely. For 12 years, it said if you had an issue of blood for a day, you had to separate yourself for 7 days in Leviticus. You were pronounced unclean. You couldn't be around everybody. So the first thing, when we within ourselves know that we have a serious issue, whatever your issues are or is, the first thing we got to do is be free from doubt. That get us, y'all, doubt because of our issues. This woman had this issue of blood for 12 years. Everywhere she went in her house reminded her of her issue. You say, I'll preach it. I'm going to tell you, Miss Matilda. She went in the bathroom. There was blood in the restroom. She sat on the couch. It was blood on the couch, blood in the bed, blood in the kitchen, everywhere, because she was confined to a house. Everywhere she went reminded her of her issue. And I'm sure we experience the same things. It's hard to shake sometimes. We think if we get in the car and listen to the right song, sometimes we think Teddy Pendergrass can kill that issue. Don't nobody know nothing about Teddy Pendergrass but me. I should have said Lil Wayne. Don't nobody know Lil Wayne but me, huh? But sometimes we think the music can just settle me. But first thing we gotta do is learn how to separate ourselves from certain people, places, and things. Separate. When you know you have a serious issue, then the second thing, we have to learn how to be still a while. Stop moving from friend to friend, from house to house, from church to church, lover to lover. Don't nobody do that in here. But be thou still a while so that we can build some confidence. Because somewhere you got to have confidence. You got to be free from doubt. You got to have confidence. And then the third thing, we got to be shown the word. What a blessing it is that City of Faith open up its doors on Thursday. Pastor come every Thursday on his post with a word from on high, feeding our soul, building our faith, building, encouraging our confidence, making us free from doubt, all from the word. Man, it's not a better choice on earth that we can make. Why? Because we have some serious issues when you have an issue, whatever your issues are. So the next thing in verse 26, it says, and the woman had suffered many things of many physicians and had spent all that she had and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. That sound like anybody? Went to all their friends, all their family members, all their loved ones, all the physicians, spent everything. We did all we thought we know what to do. And the Bible said the woman grew worse. Boy, somebody in here should shout on that, because I know I done lived that thing trying to do it myself. But God taught me somewhere I'm going to have to let him establish something in me, establish a truth in me. And nothing establishes me and you and us but his word. You, that's the only thing establish you. That's the only thing to make you confident. The only thing to make you not doubting. Only thing make you and me sure is his word. Why? Because we have a serious illness. And why? Because we've been getting secondhand information when you're thinking in yourself. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Secondhand information. And that's what she did. And that secondhand information, she was rich at one time. She had money. But she spent it all. That's what the Bible say. She spent all she had and was nothing better, but rather grew worse. Now, Matilda can tell you about that. Now, one thing I love doing is riding with Miss Matilda, and she tell us the stories about her grandmother. Her grandmother had wisdom, and so I got to ride with her a long way, not from here to her house, but on a long ride, she'll start talking about her grandmother, how that grandmother put that wisdom in her, you know, and that's what we need, because wisdom means to wise up. Somewhere we need to wise up and see that you wasting everything you got. Why? Because your thoughts ain't established. Your plans ain't established. The word will make you and me unquestionable. The word will make the decisions we make indisputable. And that's what we got to get. Why? Because when we get in secondhand information, we'll waste all that God gave us. And we say, where you at, Lord? We looking for him. And he say, I ain't never left you. You the one left. Because of all the secondhand information you get, you listen to everything. You let them, maybe they need to read my poems today. Or maybe I need to go and all that. God don't have nothing to do with that. He going to meet you in his word. The truth. Settle us. He want to fix us. Anybody ever been broken? I'm standing here today. I used to be broken, but I know beyond the shadow of a doubt, I've been fixed by Jesus, and he's still working on me. Now there's a crack in that thing. It ain't complete. It ain't, but I may not be where who I ought to be, but thank God I ain't where I used to be. Anybody know what I'm talking about? That thing getting better. It's getting lighter. I'm understanding this thing. Come on, my confidence is getting more clearer. I ain't doubting like I used to. And I'm being more sure. What? That on Thursday, Lord, if you get me there, I need to hear the word. And guess what? I ain't just talking this thing. Ain't nobody gonna beat me. I used to work on Thursday and I couldn't come. But God fixed it and you ain't gonna beat me. I don't care what they doing. They ain't gotta come, Matilda. I'm gonna be where he told me to be. And thank God, Pastor, I got somewhere I could come and sit down and hear the preacher talk about Jesus, talk about faith, help build my faith. Because some things unquestionable sometimes, because I do have an issue in some areas, but thank God for his word, y'all. This woman, in 27, to say, when she heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. Come on, y'all. Boy, something ought to fire me up. When she heard, that's what Pastor been talking about. Faith cometh. Somebody help me, by hearing the word of God. You're gonna feel defeated. You're gonna feel like you can't go no more. You're gonna feel weak. You're gonna stay in the house where the blood in the restroom, blood in the kitchen, but everything reminds you how sorry he is. Come on, how sorry she is. That's a lie. You can't change people. And you worry about everybody else's issues. He said, how you gonna talk about that speck in your brother's eye? And you got a big old plank in your own eye. Lord, help me with my issues. He said, well, it's Thursday, ain't it? Well, you need to be down. They start at 7. Thank you, Jesus, for another opportunity. And one day, this whole place is full now. It's how you see it, half empty, the glass, or half full. It don't matter because I'm here. Hello? It's full. I'm full. I'm free. And that's what we want to get, because this lady finna shout in a minute. Why? Because look at the 28. For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be made whole. Right there in 27, it says, when she had heard of Jesus, when she heard, she became, number three, a serious listener. And that's who we should profess to be. Serious listeners. It's all about him. Faith cometh by hearing. And hearing the word of God. That's all I need. Come on, the body want food. The body want Popeyes. It want churches. It want everything it see. It want to touch. It want to taste. It want to go. It want to do. But my soul cries out for the word of God. And he hungry. And he only develops and grows and become who God created me to be when I sit down and hear. I know I'm right about it. This woman, it said, when she heard that Jesus was coming, despite all the odds, she couldn't go out of house. There was a law said if you come outside, anybody could stone you to death. And she said, he coming today? I know he coming. I heard he coming. I'm going to go if I can just touch the hem of his garment. She had to crawl. She couldn't walk. She had no strength. She been bleeding for 12 years. She ain't had no money. She looked pitiful. Her hair wasn't fixed. No pedicure, no manicure, no clothes on. And she fixed in her mind, if he come by here today, I could touch the hem of his garment. I'm going to get up
out this pitiful state. I'm going to be who he created me to be. I'm going to shine like diamonds. Y'all win diamonds, but I'm going to have a diamond on the inside. Because everywhere I go, the light going to shine. Is your light shining? Carol, let your light so shine before the world. That's what it's about, preacher. Man, we get together and we just go together to shine in Jesus. Thank God for him. Thank God for his family. Thank God for the opportunity, baby. Keep on coming. Crawl, if the big wheels lock up, crawl in here. That's what she did. She crawled in. If I may just touch the hem of his garment, I'm going to be made whole. I'm going to be set free. My pitiful going to lead me to paradise. My pitiful going to make me perfect. No more pitiful, no more passing by me, no more talking about me, wagging your head at me. I'm going to touch him, and I know that I know that I know. He got power, all power to hear immediately. Immediately, it say her body, the blood stopped flowing. He said, stop leaking. Stop hemorrhaging. Nobody but Jesus can put a stop to that thing. He know just where you are. He's just waiting on you to believe. He can't work if you don't have faith. And you can't have faith if you don't come here to preach. Hello. So what a blessing and what a friend we have in Jesus. He talking about faith. He talking about something that will ignite you. He talking about something that'll make you get up off your mat and walk. The man who was at the pool waiting to get blessed, and it said the angel came and moved the water. He was waiting. Everything he owned was on that mat. He had issues. Jairus' daughter was dead. She had issues. Come on. The people that he just fed in the fourth chapter, 5,000, were hungry. They had issues. And nobody but Jesus fed him. He said, give me what you got. Somewhere our faith gonna have to be the size of a mustard seed. And faith does move mountains. I'm a living witness. Nobody but Jesus love me. Nobody but Jesus want me and you. And nobody but Jesus, Carol, she'll shout. If the preacher say you can shout, Carol, she will shout. Nobody but Jesus gonna put up with us, Carol. Darkness don't want us. That's why he lied to us. But somewhere we got to get fixed in our hearts. We got to agree upon this thing. And we got to let the word settle us. That I don't care who there. The masses, what? I'm going to be there. Yeah, the masses don't matter. As long as I'm on my post, I'm going to get what God told me he going to give me. You waiting on something? Do you need something? You got any issues? Are you free? Are you alive or are you dead? Do you know him? Have you tried him? The old preacher say, isn't it like fire shut up in your bosom? He say, won't it put running in your feet, clap it in your hands, joy bells in your heart? Nobody but Jesus. One lady who wasn't even supposed to be there. I could have went into all that. The Gentiles, she was a dog. She wasn't even supposed to get it. Crawled in, the Bible say, from behind and made him stop. Make him stop. You can do it. Make him come to your house. Stop looking at your husband. Stop looking and look in and make him stop. Because he died for you. He died for you. And everybody else who believe it, they have the opportunity to make him stop. and see about me. Lord, that's what prayer is. Keep praying. Keep a petition. Lord, help me. You know all about me. I've been going to that old preacher's study talking about faith. And come on, I take notes because I tell them what the preacher told me. That's why I take notes. I can't come here and sin. I can't remember it. He went and let the Holy Spirit put it together. He put it on this. I write all this stuff. It's right here. Because I ain't as smart as y'all. I don't remember. I don't get it like that. Lord, you got to give it to me. Come on. I meddle him because he's so intelligent. I call him Dr. J. I ain't never told him why. Because he got the medicine I need. He always have it. Every problem I have, I call him my friend, brother. And he give me the prescription, just what I need. And it ain't him. Because I done bumped heads with him. But when he let Jesus, the light shine, man, he got it. Dr. J. He's intelligent. He's articulated in all these different subjects. I ain't did that, but guess what? I articulate too because I got him. I can call him. You can call him too, baby. And tell him all about it. That's why God put him here. So your light can so shine. So you can get up off your mat. Have I went over my time, man? I'm sorry. All them other times I finish fast so I can get a little more, another minute tonight. He ain't giving them extra minute. Come on, Doc. Look, I love you. I thank God for you. But it's our faith. Our faith. It was her faith that got the miracle. That's what got it. Her faith made him say, who touched me? Now, that wasn't just, some power went out of me. This woman had an issue that the doctors couldn't heal. Nobody could fix on planet Earth. Somebody had to come all the way from heaven to Houston, Texas, and help me. And his name, Jesus. And he said, who's touched me? Man, that boy believed. The boy got faith. The young lady had faith. Can move mountains. He know just where you are. Thing ain't that big. You make it that big. I make it that big. But he ready. He ready to jump in and rescue you. All you got to do is let y'all know how you play double dust, they turn. And he ready to jump in. He waiting. That's Holy Ghost. And you won't let him come in. Fear. He said, well, I didn't give you the spirit of fear. Thank you. Come on, Doc. I love you. Thank God for you.